Nice to see you again. If you're looking for another creative method that can help you with manipulating, transforming, or improving your initial ideas, you came to the right place. The method I'll be talking about today might help you when you're stuck in your idea generation process, or when you simply have this feeling that you want to explore different perspectives and hopefully make your initial thoughts stronger by increasing its potential. It's all about creating new possibilities. So, we're going to talk about a method that, in itself, has 7 to 9 small bite-sized actions, and which is called SCAMPER. Each letter of the word SCAMPER stands for a set of actions that you can perform to manipulate your current ideas in this project. The main thing about the method is that by using one or more of the actions it suggests, you can further explore existing ideas and turn them into brand new options. And if used properly, new improved ideas might emerge in your search for alternative angles. With SCAMPER, you can find an alternative that might finally solve your problem altogether, or part of it, or even give you clues to rearrange some components or requirements for your idea. And even if nothing new comes out of this method and your initial idea still feels like the right one, SCAMPER can help you in the decision-making process by putting to the test your initial plan. Okay, let's start. SCAMPER is like a checklist of questioning actions that help in the generation of ideas. They are arranged in the following order. S stands for substitute. What can you substitute in your idea? Maybe elements, materials, colors, sizes. C stands for combine. How can you combine parts within an idea or combine different things into your idea? A stands for adapt. What can you adapt, sometimes also adopt, from other things, processes, or thoughts? M stands for both modify and magnify. How can you alter your idea by magnifying or simply modifying a detail or different parts of it? P stands for put to other uses. How can you use your idea differently? Can you think about other uses for it, other than the initial one? E stands for eliminate, which will probably help to make your case stronger. What can you possibly eliminate from the idea in a way that it still works? Finally, R stands for both reverse and rearrange. What happens if you rearrange parts or elements of your idea, or if you reverse its logic and way of being? In total, you have at least 7 small steps that might be used together, isolated in sets or in a different order. Whatever you and your potential design ideas might need, the productive thing about SCAMPER is that it makes you question certain givens or details you take for granted. And it does this by helping you to look at things from a different perspective, which is the whole purpose of using creative methods in the first place. However, bear in mind that putting your ideas through the SCAMPER process might not automatically mean they are foolproof, but it does help. Let's find an example to follow through that addresses some of the actions in the method. One fairly well-known example of SCAMPER, though probably an urban myth by now, is the case of the founder of a fast food company. This is how the story goes. Once upon a time, there was this gentleman who was a seller of milkshake machines. One day, he joined 2 brothers in a small business of burger stands in California. After a while, he decided it was time to change things, and this is what happened. He substituted his partners by finding venture capitalists. Because he was cash poor and the brothers did not seem to follow his ambition into a bright new project. He then adapted an idea. He picked up the brothers' simple idea of selling a burger in a paper bag with French fries for a quick snack. And hooray! Make it easy, simplified, standardized, and fast food was invented. He then put it to another use. In this case, through franchising, selling restaurants and real estate, instead of simply selling burgers. He then eliminated, letting customers serve themselves, avoiding the use of waiters. He finally reversed, having customers pay before they eat. Interesting. As a side note, the more your brain asks these type of questions while you're designing, the smoothest scamper will be for you to use. It does take time to get used to going through the whole 7 steps by heart. It is quite important that, as with other techniques that you might use to become unstuck, you must be able to put on hold any critical opinions or the urge to dismiss alternatives as too crazy. Again, the purpose of SCAMPER is to open your thinking process to new things and not primarily evaluate or test the feasibility of an idea. So, to sum up, SCAMPER usually works best when you already have some ideas that need to be shaken up, manipulated, and explored. It can be flexibly approached by using it in its entirety or only parts of it, and in any other way that's appropriate. So, good luck, and let's see how far you get.